case you don't know me, my name is Megan Schutt. I grew up in the magical suburbs of Hackham West with a younger brother and an older sister, and my mum and dad, of course, and then in the backyard was pretty much where we played all our cricket. It was a pretty competitive backyard, that's for sure, but it was long and straight, and that is the only reason why I can play a straight drive and I can't cut to save my life. So. As a kid, I was a bit of a terror at times, but I like to think I was a gift. I remind my parents every day I could have been much worse. I don't know, I was a free spirit. I kind of did whatever I wanted. Luckily, my parents weren't overly strict. So it was a free-flowing childhood, that's for sure. But I was about 11 years old when the kids down the road asked me to fill in for their local boys team. And it happened to be that one game that I filled in for, and I was terrible. I got bowled first ball, I put the pads on the wrong legs, it was horrible. There happened to be a scout there for the women's game, and I got scooped into playing with an Incredible for the next couple weekends, and before I knew it, I was in state underage stuff, not really knowing what I was doing. I actually had really good grades at school. I wasn't there a whole lot for high school, I will be honest. I skipped a few lessons here and there, but I always had a good rapport with my teachers, and I actually had really good grades, so for someone that kind of came off as a bit of a rebel, I kept my grades up at the same time. My first match for Australia was actually not the best one. I don't think I got a wicket in that game, and I did not expect to be playing at all. I got a knock on the door the night before. I thought I was going to be stirring the cordial for years to come. So that was a bit of a shock to me, but thank you, Sarah Coit, for getting an injury. I believe it was to your quad. You provided me with my first game for Australia. I'm your standard athlete. I love a good coffee. I love spending time at the beach and just spending time with friends and family, because you don't get to do all that much. Yeah, I've always been pretty honest. That's the way I describe myself, is honest. Some say blunt, some say straight to the point. Honest is a better word. I don't know, I've never been good at sugarcoating. I grew up with my dad like that. That's how he told it to us. So I think with lots of things that can be a bit controversial, you know, such as same-sex marriage and all that kind of stuff, it definitely took me to kind of be comfortable within myself before I started voicing those opinions. But I learned that it's better to just be yourself and do that and then regret not saying anything. If I believe that it's a topic that I can discuss and debate with some knowledge behind it, then it's definitely something I'll reply to, because at the end of the day, that's how we all change our views. And I know for me, you know, you're meant to change as a person and grow. So without those discussions, you can't do that.